Hello, CHKN Army. Today we are going to scour the vast landscape in search of resources to build a thriving homestead. It's the art of survival. To feel the absolute effect of survival, we must be in adventure mode. As you can see, in adventure mode, we will start off with nothing. And so we must begin our quest to gather a plethora of resources in order to craft our way up to building a home and farm in order to thrive. When you begin, it's really all about gathering out of necessity in order to keep yourself alive, and almost everything you see around you can be gathered. You may find a branch or two lying around for defense, or you can use it, or your bare fists, to take down trees and break apart rocks for some raw materials. As you can see in the hotbar below, many objects will have a green bar, which signifies its durability status. Other necessary items are food, which will help keep you full and not starve, so make sure you gather enough food for yourself, and always keep an eye on your hunger bar. Once you feel you have a decent source of materials, you can now press the I key to open up your inventory and crafting window. It may not seem like a lot can be crafted at the moment, but that's okay, because as you gather more resources or craft items, additional objects will begin to appear. Using just the caretaker, only the most basic objects can be crafted, but they are enough to get us going in this early stage. I'm going to need some logs, which is a basic crafted material that's used for many other objects. With my mouse hovered over the log, you will see a pop-up appear that shows the required ingredients. Remember how I said when you craft something basic, additional objects may appear? Well, as you can see, crafting one log brings up several more objects in the crafting window. A good object to start with will be the workbench. But uh-oh, it looks like I'll need 6 logs to craft this object, given that I have the required amount of tree trunk parts in my inventory, which I do. Alright, now that I have all 6 logs, you will see that the workbench's icon has been colored in, and is no longer semi-transparent. This makes it easy for the eye to see what can be crafted now, and what needs additional ingredients or workstations. There we go! I'm going to place the workbench in my hotbar now, so I can, in turn, place it somewhere on the ground. For the time being, of course. Now I can begin crafting other needed objects that require the workbench, such as the hatchet. Additionally, I would also like to craft the furnace, which at this point is a good source to make more powerful food items. Thankfully, the furnace only requires 6 rocks, so after crafting this, I'm going to use the apples I still have and bake them. Now that they're baked, they will fill up my stomach more quickly than if they were raw, which will in turn help me survive longer. Okay, if all this seems a bit daunting, never fear. Keep in mind that creatures roam the land. You can always tame a wild one, but that will use up your precious food inventory. Or you can try to gather life blocks from their eggs, or the creatures themselves, in order to build your own. Remember that it is recommended to attach a mouth, eyes, and legs. Whichever way you decide to obtain a creature, you can eventually use the whistle to order them to break down trees, rocks, and eggs, so you don't have to. As with the method of ordering your creature to attack another creature, you can simply point the crosshair at a resource and right click. So what can you do after all your time gathering and crafting? Well, I don't know about you, but I would like to get a roof over my head. And thus, we can finally start building our own home and farm. Both are simple enough, as farming only requires you to till the ground first with any blunt object like the hatchet or even a branch, and then plant any seeds you may have gathered or crafted. The source will pop up instantly, but may take time for the actual food to grow. No matter the weight, farming is very beneficial as it can provide a constant source of food to feed yourself and your creatures. Structure building is also easy, as most structure blocks are 3x1 squares, which helps save time in the end. However, what makes CHKN structure building unique is its ability to auto-form in order to fit into smaller crevices or attach itself to slopes. Like building a creature, you can press the E key to rotate structure parts. Building structures and pins for you and your creatures are very important, as they provide safety from outside attacks and also prevent your creatures from wandering off. You can also place a trough in your creature's pin and fill it with food to keep your creature fed. Once you understand these simple concepts, the world is at your fingertips. You know, after all that hard work we put in, this really does feel like home sweet home. And it looks like my friend is enjoying himself too. Well, I do want to thank you for watching, and make sure you subscribe to us on YouTube, sign up for our newsletter, and head on over to our Steam store page for more awesome content. You can find the links in the description below.